Curious George, the curious little monkey. Oh, what fun to run and jump and play. Curious George, the curious little monkey. Let's go see what he's doing today.
Curious George and the Greenhouse. Let's drive over to Mr. Anderson's greenhouse this morning, George, said the man with the yellow hat. Looks like we need new plants for the flower boxes. After breakfast, they got in their little blue car and were on their way. They parked the car in front of the greenhouse. I'm going to ask Mr. Anderson what kind of plants I should get, George, said the man with the yellow hat. You look around, but don't get into trouble. And off he went to see the owner. Mr. Anderson was talking to a lady in a straw hat. I'm in charge of this year's charity ball, said the lady, and I'm looking for something special as a centerpiece for the speaker's table. I'll pay a good price for it. George had gone to the next greenhouse. In one corner, there were some tall palm trees. Another corner was filled with flowers. George smelled the hyacinths, and the magnolias, and the violets, and some little yellow flowers. They smelled so sweet and so strong. He got dizzy from all that smelling. Finally, he had to sit down. Mr. Anderson and the lady with the straw hat had come over to look for the special centerpiece. By now, George was feeling a little better. He saw a big round wheel on the wall. What did that do? George was curious. He went over to investigate the situation. He grabbed the wheel with both hands and turned it. Water sprayed everywhere. It was the sprinkling system that watered the flowers. George jumped around in the water just as if he were taking a shower. Who turned that water on? Asked Mr. Anderson.
I'm getting wet and the water will ruin my hat, said the lady. She was trying to keep it dry, but her hat was drowning. Mr. Anderson rushed over, grabbed the wheel, and shut the water off.
The lady in the straw hat ran over to George.
So it was you, she cried. Look what you've done to my new hat.
It was time for George to get away. Finally, he reached a big tree covered with vines. Now George knew what to do. He jumped up, leaped over, and swung through the vines. He was just about to grab another vine when his foot kicked a hanging plant and knocked it off its hook. Luckily, he caught the plant before it crashed to the ground. Just then, the lady with the wet straw hat ran over, followed by Mr. Anderson, followed by the man with the yellow hat. There he is, she shouted, and pointed toward George. Grab him before he does any more damage. Mr. Anderson looked up.
But look what he did. He saved our rare African orchid.
That's just the plant I want for my charity ball, cried the lady. Please hand it to me, George.
Then she turned to Mr. Anderson. Well, she said, let's forget about my hat. When it dries, it'll be like new. You'll certainly have all my flower business from now on, thanks to your little helper.
George, said Mr. Anderson, we had to water the flowers anyway, but next time you visit our greenhouse, let us do the sprinkling.
And now, my friend, I've got another job for you, said the man with the yellow hat. You can help me plant some flowers in our flower boxes.
George and the man with the yellow hat waved goodbye, and off they went in their little blue car.